Hello and welcome, everybody. It's your good friend Furluge, also known as Don in Meat Space, and we are back for another wonderful episode of the show here today. I hope everything sounds okay, because before we got started, I completely messed up, like, every config I had for the stream. There's a button on my mixer, which, if I hit it, it will make it sound like Satan has possessed my soundboard. I think the audio in general just might be too loud. Yikes. I don't remember everything this period being quite this loud. I don't know. The mixer board says it's fine. Maybe I just have better connection, because I went through everything just to realize, oh, idiot me hit the wrong button. How wonderful that is. So anyway, we are back, and of course, make sure the green screen looking okay, because last time I really kind of messed up the green screen. Like, you could see it. And like the videos there, I don't know how I managed to do that, but it looks good right now. So hopefully everything will be okay. Of course, I have our good friend Sammy here, who just loves fighting Ridley so very much. Again and again. Anyway, we're gonna continue with Other M. I'm happy to say we are officially past the halfway point. If we're not actually at the halfway point, I'm gonna call bullshit, because you had me fight Ridley. Like, we should be long past halfway point now, I think, at this point. So anyway, I can actually get Crystal Pepsi now. I'm so happy. I mean, I don't know. Like, some of the boss fights have been fun in this game. You know, not the worst things ever. Oh, right, the story. I've got to read the story. When Samus arrives at the geothermal power plant, she comes face to face with her arch nemesis, Ridley. For the third time, she murdered that fucker. Anthony attempts to protect the panic-stricken Samus from Ridley, even though she killed him three fucking times already, and falls into the depths of the lava that fuels the power plants because Samus is too much of a weak little flower to fight the monster that she's killed three fucking times already. Samus's anger returns her to her senses. She attacks Ridley with wild shots with her plasma beam, but he manages to narrowly escape. Then the game bugs out and she has to do it all over again, and watch the PTSD scene again. Stricken with grief and remorse, Samus is further rebuilt at the lack of the communication from Adam. Driven by anxiety, Samus sets out for the main sector. Along the way, she encounters a lone Federation soldier who is en route to Sector 1. And the game decides that we can't go to the main sector because it decreed that we would go to Sector 1. Even though every other time we've been allowed to go to the main sector and explore, not this time. Now fuck you for exploring. In a Metroid game, you should know better. Man, I'm already getting mad. So anyway, we got all the beams, okay? We got the plasma beams. We got the wave beams. Like, there's no more beams unless they give us a spacer, and they're not gonna give us a spacer. Okay, these things are different. Uh-oh, they actually got me. Oh, yeah, that's right. It fucking goes through enemies. I forgot about that. Fuck out of the monster. And then that is a grapple beam point. I can see it. How do I get to it? So, I need to get out of this room and into the jungle area. Now, how do I mean, I see there is broken glass there, but the only thing I have, I don't really have anything to get up there with. The only thing I have is the Shine Spark. Shine Spark requires me to run, and I'm not going to be able to make, yeah, because there's turns in both directions. Damn it, this is so annoying. I said I know something is there. I know something's here, too. Let's see how this goes. I remember the jungle area actually feeling quite expansive. Oh. There goes the deleter. Or another... Oh, you sons of bitches. That's how you fight the monsters, kiddies. Blow the shit out of them before they ever get near you. I don't know why he would get into that melee bullshit with them. Like, I have a gun. Let's see, is there anything that screams use your grapple beam on it? Or what have you? So like I said, I see the item there. Just have to find the thing it wants me to use. Okay. Maybe if I could see it, I'd have a hint what the game wants me to do. Oh, I bet I need to Shine Spark up there. Because this counts as running in one direction. You know, even though we're kind of curving around this thing. There we go, that's what it wanted. Yay! Own missile. Thanks, game. I didn't know what a missile tank does. Actually, I know what a missile tank does. It gives you 5 missiles. This is more like a missile sub-tank, a missile mini-tank. It's not really a missile tank. You know, I could go that way. You know, I have a sneaking suspicion that I am going to get down here. And the game is going to tell me that the doorway is closed. Or who knows, maybe that was the one, maybe that was the door that the leader went through. God, those things still scare me. Oh, there we go, there's a grapple beam. Yay. Ooh. Does this actually let me go anywhere else? No. Uh-oh, hold on. I saw an energy thingamabob up there. You guys see what I saw? Yeah, that is... That's an E-tank up there. How the fuck are you supposed to get to that? Oh, there's just nothing there. You can't... You can't shine spark up there. Oh no! Not the save room! Anything but the save room? There's another energy part. I feel like that one I could find if I... Yeah, I should have seen that the first time I came through. Darn it. Yay, that was my multiple of four, so it's good, more energy for me. We picked that up. Oh, and this door is locked. Of course it is. Man, I can't believe I missed that thing. It was so easy, I just had to go to the damn grate. Wow, even the leader wants me to go to the nav booths. I'm not crazy about Crystal Pepsi, but it's... I feel like if I don't drink it now, I'll never get to drink it again. What is ticking? That what you wanted me to see, that he closed the bridge?
Objection, Adam.
Well, at least... at least she got over her problems, finally. That's all I'm gonna say. Thank goodness. Wow, it is still difficult to gain height with the space jump. You do have to time this right. You cannot fuck around with the space jump. Oh, god damn it. I don't have the timing down. Here we go. Can I just leave this room? No. Oh, shoot, because there's shit back that way. No, it's just the elevator. And we're back to slow walking RE mode. I guess I'll save here. I can't go back and get those items I wanted. That would be wrong. Just let the damn game railroad me. I don't care. The timing is fairly tight on the space jump in this. I am happy that now that Samus is not hearing from Adam, like, I do like that any objections, Adam line. It's nice to see Samus acting more normal, more herself. That being said, don't know why she didn't ask to, like, turn on her various suit and other things. You know, admittedly, like, you do have reason to be afraid of Samus. She is...
I'm not a member of the Galactic Federation. I'm here because I intercepted the distress call. I'm a bounty hunter.
That makes it so much better.
That something is after you. Please, you must believe me. Thank you. I'm Samus Aran. What's your name?
Madeline Bergman.
Yay.
Behind closed doors, the Galactic Federation was trying to create a special forces unit composed of bioweapons.
And we're just going to tell everybody.
They were attempting to create an organization modeled after the space pirates, with the Zabesians at the center. But because of a certain presence, the life forms became ferocious. We were no longer able to control them.
By a certain presence, she must have meant Ridley. So you sent out the distress signal, even though it endangered your life?
I had to. I felt there was a real danger here, that if left as is, the Zabesians would continue to evolve and resurrect as real space pirates.
If that danger was real, and the risk of withholding information to protect herself was too great, and yet, wasn't she the one who set the facility's system to self-destruct? In silence, I praised her courage and sense of responsibility.
Nothing's been set to self-destruct yet.
Her argument had some holes. Say that the Zabesians, under Ridley's influence, became super aggressive. Did that really lead to the resurrection of the space pirates? Without a malicious force to lead them down that path, wouldn't they continue to merely follow their instincts, ultimately becoming no more than a swarm of creatures? Regardless, it was clear that the Galactic Federation was ready to consign their enormous mistake to oblivion. And that's why they sent a deleter. And as for Madeline and others who knew the secret? But wait. There was another inconsistency in her story. Why go to such lengths at all? With just a small flexing of the Galactic Federation's military force,
yeah,
they should have been able to destroy a facility of this scope with ease. So why didn't they?
Actually, there was an even more dangerous plan. Come with me.
What? That's not possible. The Metroids were terminated along with Zebes.
No, yes. They were terminated with the SR-388.
The baby.
The baby.
Met its end above my head.
You're Samus Aran, right? The one who annihilated the...
This does not answer why they didn't just blow up the station.
Metroid remnants were attached to your suit when you returned from Zebes. They were reproduced from a piece of cell structure salvaged by the Federation, and they are in this facility.
I gave your suit a polish so you'd be at least somewhat presentable.
And Ridley in the same way.
At first, no one thought that the creature was Ridley. They didn't think it had potential as a bioweapon at all. They raised it like a pet, calling it Little Birdie. Until one day, it attacked one of the researchers and got away. Ridley had played dead and lured the scientist into his cage.
I haven't told you he's Ridley yet.
Was left. It was a horrible sight.
But in order to control Metroids, you need Mother Brain's telepathy.
Ridley is the bunny from...
You don't. You didn't recreate a Mother Brain clone, did you?
No, Madeline Bergman.
It's artificial intelligence. We developed an AI program that would reproduce Mother Brain's thought processes. We called it MB.
But it was just a program. It wasn't the mother herself.
MB evolved as it communicated with Metroids. It appears as though it became self-aware, much like the original Mother Brain. It's really quite remarkable.
That's when it became clear to me.
Tell me more.
Why Madeline was so afraid of the space pirate's resurrection.
Madeline Bergman about MB.
It wasn't that her story had holes in it. Through the holes were glimpses of the danger that was right before her eyes. If everything she said was true.
Where are the Metroids and MB?
They're in an area called Sector Zero. It's a unit that doesn't appear in any of our map data. It's a place like Turian, where we propagate and raise Metroids.
I began to see what the worst-case scenario would look like. The ultimate weapon, Metroid, would be mass-produced, and as soon as an AI that could control them was developed, the plan to create a special forces unit modeled after the space pirates was replaced. As the AI called MB spun out of control, the facility became a place much like the planet Zebes. If the situation were left alone, galactic society would be put in peril. Even the leaders of the operation wanted to avoid that.
You could just blow up the station! Okay.
That's why. They decided to capture the Metroids contained in Sector Zero and delete the rest of the facility, including the space pirates, Ridley, and everyone who knew the secret. But before the ringleaders could act, Adam appeared. Adam might have known or suspected the truth about the facility from the beginning. Regardless, since the ringleaders were members of the Galactic Federation, they could no longer act recklessly. So a deleter was installed as a member of Adam's team to destroy evidence and plan each subsequent move. But having me added on as a member must have disrupted the Galactic Federation's plans.
Madeline, thanks for telling me all this. I've got to destroy the Metroids and MB in Sector Zero. You have to remain hidden.
Her name is Madeline Bergman.
Don't worry. The Galactic Federation CO, who's here now, will help you. Safe.
You don't even know if he's in one piece.
Does that CO happen to be Commander Adam Malkovich?
Why do you know who he is? Why are we on an elevator?
The real leader of this operation is Commander Malkovich. I can't believe it.
Stay here until I return.
Why couldn't we have just told us that? Rather than doing this weird cutscene thing. The kind of weird back and forth. But again, her name is Madeline Bergman. We're not being subtle in this game. Oh no! Not Madeline Bergman! Okay, so now the door has magically locked, thus meaning we have to go back the way we came. And oh look, we can actually go back over here now. Whoa! There's a lot of these dudes. I don't remember there being a lot here before. Now, why can't I go there? Like, there are things that way. Why do you keep doing this to me, game? I finally get the chance to go back and collect the objects, but I can't because you locked the door on me. Maybe if I save. Maybe then you'll let me go there. No. I can already tell. That's what that little red icon means, isn't it? The fuck you. Yeah. God damn it. I know there's a thing over there that you can get with the speed booster, which I now have. Like, I found it earlier. Why are there so many dudes here all of a sudden? Nope, it's gonna lock me off from that boy too. Well, at the very least, I can get whatever it was over here. God, that noise is obnoxious. Right, that's right, I gotta aim at it. Oh! Okay, it's just an energy part. Still good. Still good. I still like energy parts. It's one of those things up here, there. Uh-oh, get off me. Jesus Christ, you're just gonna throw shit tons of them at me, aren't you? Okay, it wants me to go back to the main sector, so let's not go back to the main sector. You know, I have to be extra careful because the game will just randomly decide I can't go someplace like that. Will randomly decide decide I can't do that. I like how we have to have a locked door indicator. Look at them invisible walls. All right. Heaven forbid I go get the things I know I can get. No! What the f- Okay. I suppose this creature again. Oh, thank God. Get whatever those things are. That better be swarm missiles. Or is it power bombs? Seeker missiles. Multiple missiles charge up a super missile when multiple targets are locked fire. Alright, so I've seen one door that will do that. Maybe, just maybe, game will let me go off the rails. Come on. I finally have the space jump. There has to be a way I can get up there. Like, I just gotta get the arc right. It's very hard to get altitude with this space jump in this game. Especially when it's not. I feel like I should be able to do this. Can't seem to get where those grapples are either. And it so looks like I should be able to get over there. Oh, I feel like I must be doing something wrong. So incredibly frustrating. So incredibly frustrating. Oh. Okay. Right, there's no other elevator here. Let's go back up.
This elevator is bound for the main sector.
Yay. Oh, goodbye, Crystal Pepsi. I'm still not exactly sure what you taste like, other than sugar. No, I can't leave the main sector again either. I must go to Sector 2. I don't even know why I'm going to Sector 2.
This elevator.
Again, I know where there's items in Sector 1. I know where there's items in Sector 2. I have the upgrades to get them now, but I am not allowed to go get them because of the doors. Oh yeah, I got that thing. A whole missile. I mean, granted, we do use 5 missiles a pop now, and only get them one at a time, so more missiles is always good. Oh my god, are you kidding me? I just missed it. Just like that? Wow. Man, I just walked by some of this shit like an idiot. You know what? Yeah, wait, I've got space jump. Just let's fucking avoid that bullshit. This part I'm not so sure about. Okay. The item is definitely in the next room, so there's that. Yay! We can finally finish it off. What speed boost is the answer? Oh no, no, not like that though. Speed boost is not the answer like that. There we go. Oh. Even better. Sweet! Got two missile tanks doing that shit. Feel lucky there, because I did not really... I feel like I just kind of blundered into that spot because there was that this little divot. Just happened to have that in there. That thing. And that's got the swarm door that I saw earlier. But we're not gonna go that way. We're gonna go this way. A, there's a save point here. But B, there's an item on the map this way. And if I don't get it now, who knows when the game will deign to let me go get it. I'm gonna be honest, I'm not even 100% sure this leads to where I want to go. Oh, I'm hitting a wall. There's a missile over there. How in the hell did he get to that thing? Like, there's a wall right here, so I can't just go over to it. Yeah. Like, it looks like it would be beneath this tree, but you can't just walk over there and get it. Oh, God damn it. Okay, so that frightened me a tiny bit. I feel like there should be a morph ball entrance someplace. Something I can bomb, or like a little smudge. All I'm finding is invisible wall, though. And then we're back here again. Grapple points. Oh, nothing. How does one get there? I'm just not seeing it. I feel like there should be something there. There's gotta be a way to get over to that thing. It's obviously not jumping over the waist-high fence. Wait, maybe this is it. Maybe this is, yes. Oh, they already respawned, huh? Wow. I feel pretty good for noticing that now. I mean, I should have noticed it before, but, you know. It's fairly well concealed. Alright, this is the thing that has a... as far as the super missiles, I remember. Come on, save the game. Oh shoot, I'm missing something in the Twitch chat. Hey Banjo, I'm sorry. Gosh darn it. Man, I missed that a while back. Bad me, I'm sorry. I got so used to looking up there, I forgot I had the YouTube chat up there instead. I forget where the hell this goes. Oh. Huh. Yeah, that's the noise I was hearing. So this map's getting a little confusing right here. Because it's got... It doesn't do verticality well because it's 2D. God, I hated those things the first time going through here. I know I shouldn't get too complacent, because I do know not every item appears on the map. We have established that pretty clearly. Shoot through glass now. What? That unlocks a missile? Sure, why not? It unlocks a missile. Missile tanks increase the missile capacity by 1. But you didn't know that. I mean, we've only seen that, what? Oh God, I can't count. We've only seen it 42 minus 5 times. You know, it's so ridiculous. I'm just so happy this game is actually letting me... Ooh, I can feel it slowing down. Oh, there's that dead body from earlier. Alright, let's see if we can find this last blinky item that we know about. Oh, but that's not the item. It's here. All right, I remember this. It wouldn't let me go back, and I can see where the item was now. There's a morph ball hole right here. It's literally right there. Wow. Well, nothing else I can say. We did. We did manage to finally go through a whole area without the game messing with us, letting us go around and collect items. Oh, look, I even found an item in the crates. Neat, it's an energy part. Holy shit, are these all? No. Okay. Not every crate is a winner. It's, of course, the power loader we killed earlier. My name just walked by something important. Let's see here. Save room. So at this point, I'm just going to be backtracking to get to where I was before. It'd be really convenient if there were grapple points here. I mean, there aren't, but it'd be convenient. Still, I think the space jump helps. Killed those things. I really hate those things. I guess we're gonna fight a few of those on the way here. Huh. Well, at least we're getting close to getting another super missile, I suppose. So we're going to have to go all the way back to that swarm door. So far, I've only seen one swarm door. I would like to finish this soon because Breath of the Wild is coming out and I do have that pre-ordered. I think we'll play Breath of the Wild when it comes out. Side of the station. I do love the view here, I'll say that much. It's very cool looking going around the outside of the space station in 3D. Alright. That spits us out back here. Alrighty, so we just gotta go back through. Oh, so much for trying to shine spark over that. This was not gonna happen. And skip those stupid aliens down there. Alrighty, so we're back here again, and now it's time. Yeah, I know, I figured it out, game. I already know this is where this is the only thing. Oh wow, it automatically locks on to the things. Here we go, into the new section. Thank you. only I had like a gravity suit that would help me. Yay. That was surprisingly more difficult than I think it should have been. You know, you can't even see me. You, like, don't even know I'm here. Again! Okay, gravity section's over with. Wow, okay, this is heavy gravity now. Yep. Jesus. Interesting. Huh. That's kind of cool. Poor little flying dudes who would normally be trying to ambush me are just all getting destroyed by this gravity. Oh, fuck you. Why are you guys not getting affected? Execute him. Why are they bouncing around with no problem? I don't get it. Like, they should be getting affected by the gravity the same I am. The other monsters were, so it's not a one-time thing. Okay. Oh, and I just can't do it. It's the gravity. Darn it. Can I get a save station? It's been a long time since I've had a save station. Oh, God. Oh, that's not gonna work. Oh. What the hell is here? Well, it's not there. God, I'm not really sure what I'm supposed to do. I see there is a grapple beam farther up, but... like, there's one there. I can't get a lock on it. And I drop way too fast to get anywhere with the space jump. And this wall is in the way. Oh no. I was just over exaggerating. I could have done it at any time. Oh boy. This is gonna be tricky. Good God, I've... anything else? Oh, okay. No. Yeah, there is something else. Something else is I'm going the wrong way. Crap, there are still no saves. Nope. That gravity is still on. Well, there's a save. And I think we've got a boss battle coming up here. Ooh, Sector Zero. Okay. Is that the thing that's fucking with gravity? Probably. Something is not right here. These setups are too contrived with the grapple beam. Yeah, okay. There we go. Oh, Oh, it's that thing from Zero Mission. Or, no, it's from Fusion. That computer thing from Fusion. It's got like the green face in Fusion. Oh, now he's fucking with gravity. Okay, this... Concentrate, concentrate, concentrate!
Thank you.
Why won't you let me shoot you in the face? It won't lock onto his fucking face. Oh, I'm gonna die right here. Nope, I'm not gonna die right there. Charge. Oh, I just had to hit it with one regular missile. Oh no. Yep, that's the thing from Fusion, all right. It's got the face and all that shit. I do not trust that thing to not come back to life and try to kill me. Alright! That is gonna... I just had to hit it with one stupid regular missile. I kept trying to charge my missiles. Stupidly. So that is gonna be it for today's broadcast. We have killed this monstrosity thing from Fusion. That is definitely a reference to that thing from Fusion. I don't know if we'll have to fight another one again. Man, it's been a long time since I played Fusion. So, until next time, which will be tomorrow at 7 p.m., I don't expect there to be any more technical problems. This is your good friend Furtloose signing off, saying, have a good evening, everybody.
It's in that box!
It's in the box, dog!
It's a fucking wizard!